So, I do want to make a new kitchen table for in our house, and for that I want to make V-formed feet. So the bottom leg will be 650 millimeters wide, and the top will be 800 millimeters wide. That way you get a little bit the feet sitting in an angle. So I calculated that I need to make a cut of 84 degrees in total. So that's 42 degrees on each piece of steel. And then I get a total height of 72 centimeters from the table on the bottom side. So then we gotta set the saw to an angle of 42 degrees. So I got all the legs for the table sawed, and now it's time to weld them up and straighten them out, because I don't want a table that sits under an angle. It has to be perfect level, otherwise your stuff would roll off the table, and that's something that we don't like. So this is one of the table feet now. I straightened this out so it's nice and flat, and if it's painted then you cannot see that there's a weld sitting there anymore. Only the inside that will still remain a weld, but I think that's always looking pretty if you have a weld on the inside, and these welds will also remain. So I'm gonna weld a plate in here. So that hole is completely closed, and I will flatten that out with the grinder so it will be perfectly flat and you will not notice that it was welded. That way it will look really neat and clean even if you don't get to touch it. But it should be nice for a table, so let's do that. So I got the frame finished and it looks a bit small, but it's big enough for a big table. It turned out to be quite a decent table, so I'm very happy with the result. And I'm also very happy that everything is straight. It didn't warp too bad when welding it, so that's really good. Now it's time to see if we can get the wood on top of here, because that's the next step. And if that all fits, then everything can be painted and eventually it can be assembled and it's finished. So I got all the wood ready to saw pieces of it. Now it's time to choose what pieces to use for making what kind of table, because it all depends on what I can make of it, because I have no clue yet. So to be able to make straight cuts, I use this piece of steel here over the complete length of the saw, and I know that this one is perfect straight. And I use a piece of board, which I did saw on a perfect straight angle, and that way I can hold the board against the steel, and that will deliver me a perfectly straight cut. This way I can saw my planks in straight lines. So let's see how that goes. I used the angle grinder in combination with a steel brush to take off the bark, and this went pretty well. So I got everything glued up now. I found these two huge clamps at my uncle's place, and they come in very useful now to make this. The complete table is clamped together nicely this way. First I sanded the whole tabletop, and after that I put epoxy on to fill up all the holes that are in here, as these planks are natural wood and they do have holes, and that needs to be covered up. And I did it in multiple layers until the holes were completely filled up and it could sand it all flat again. I decided to paint the tabletop with high gloss clear paint, so it will give a really shiny table, but I think that's justified for this table. And finally it's time to place the table inside, so we first have to take out the old table before we can put the new table in place, and we have to assemble it in the kitchen because otherwise we cannot get it in, as it's way too heavy to lift it in if the frame and the tabletop are mounted together. I'm really happy with the result, and I think this experiment has succeeded because we have now a nice and shiny table in the kitchen. Maybe it's a little bit too shiny for the kitchen, but I think it suits the table well, as it will really stand out in the room. Of course the table is still warping a little bit over time, and that's because it's natural wood and it wants to warp, but nothing bad has happened till yet, so that's good. And it's standing inside already for a month. It's always a little bit of extra special if a table is made out of the tree from your own garden, because this tree first stood outside for about 80 to 100 years, and now it can stand inside for probably 50 years or until it breaks or we are tired of it. So that's a really neat thought. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe if you want to see more, because I will posting a lot more videos in this time as spring is coming and we have a lot of work to do in your yard. Unfortunately, this is a special project for me and it's not the stuff that I regularly post on my channel. Thank you for watching.